on his boxing, but he immediately shoots in for the takedown. Bibiano is able to control the top game and end up on top. Now he's trying to step over. This is where we rarely see McLaren. We rarely see him on his back. Bibiano slides him right over to the cage.
He gets wheelbarrowed into the cage wall.
And what that's going to do, that's going to prevent Reece McLaren from throwing up any submission attempts because he's not able to create any space. And Bibiano is going to be able to pressurize him, suck a little bit of his energy out, and dish out a little bit of ground and pound.
Ridiculous strength from Fernandez to upend McLaren like that. And McLaren is a very strong young man.
Oh, man, I've spent a lot of time on the mat with Bibiano, and it is incredibly frustrating that a man that size can control you so easily, just manhandles people.
Last fight for Bibiano was back in January of this year when he beat Kevin Belingon, Filipino.
That was nice. McLaren tried to put his foot on Bibiano's hip, but Bibiano was just able to sidestep it out and pass right over. McLaren's good on him, though, to get back up to his feet.
Sends in that left hand from the southpaw stance, McLaren.
Yes, baby, good. Look for your pressure.
McLaren's being active on his feet, staying nice and light on his toes. Throwing out strikes, landing some. Bibiano closes the distance. Got to make sure he keeps his hands up, though. Bibiano trying to go for that knee tap takedown. McLaren able to fight it off. Ooh. Inside leg kick landed by Bibby.
Approaching the midway point in the first round. This, remember, five 5-minute rounds, and judges will score the contest in its entirety. Quite a few of Bibiano's fights go the distance.
Nice, able to slide under that punch, lace up those legs. Now he's trying to work his waist into mount, but McLaren's doing the right thing. Got that butterfly guard going on, trying to fight off the legs there.
Not many fighters in the world who have the experience of going five rounds the extent that Bibiano Fernandez does. Knows exactly how to pace himself.
Now Bibiano's got him cradled in. Let's go with that. McLaren's got that butterfly guard where his hands are his shins are on the inside of Bibiano's thighs. But it's so hard. I mean, McLaren just got received his black belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, but like Bibiano's been a black belt for most of his life. So he submits and regularly beats other black belts. So his jiu-jitsu is just on a completely another level. But McLaren's doing a really good job because this is MMA. And the punches change things. Being able to punch changes a jiu-jitsu fighter's game. Now McLaren's looks like he's got a half guard, sort of a hat, like a lockdown position on that foot where Bibiano's a little bit harder for him to get out of it.
Crowd here totally absorbed in this one, Mitch. Full house here at the Mall of Asia Arena.
I like how Bibiano uses his head. He's always got his head in the right position. So he's trying to put his head up against the chin of McLaren just to make sure he can't quite move as well. He can also pin him to the ground.
Chance of Bibby, I think, from the crowd behind me. He's a very popular fighter.
Bibiano is a methodical jiu-jitsu player. He's going to slowly try to pass the guard, end up in side control, work to the mount, go for the finish.
Watch out your head, watch out the head.
Yeah, Bibiano's head came down on McLaren's. No question that it was intentional, but that's what Olivier Coste is just having a word about.
This could be a long fight, Steve, because McLaren is showing good jiu-jitsu defense. He's able to secure a lot of positions and defend quite well. So he's going to make Bibiano work for this, and this fight could be contested or decided on their feet.
Final 10 seconds of the opening round then. D88.com fight of the night if you're a big fan of chess matches, enduring contests.
You know, he can outwork Bibiano here and really land some significant strikes and possibly outwork him because the striking could be even here. And look at this, McLaren going for the takedown. And that's what he's known for. We're not used to seeing McLaren on his back. Look at him trying to get inventive. I like this. I like the confidence that he's showing here.
Certainly.
Ooh,
going
nice
for
right
it.
Hand landed by Bibiano.
Pressing the champion up against the cage. And he will get a taste of McLaren's strength.
Now he's trying to press the champion up against the cage, trying to possibly work for a takedown. Much more aggressive, you know, offense from McLaren.
Forearm and elbow smashed into Fernandez's face there as he came off the cage.
I also like the angles that he's working out. He kind of shuffles his feet and then circles to the outside of Bibiano, away from his power hand, and then setting up some strikes. So he's giving Bibby some different looks to try to, you know, understand. See, Bibiano's gonna catch that leg
yeah,
kick.
Yeah, he's done it several times, hasn't he?
Catches the leg kick, closes the distance. But look at McLaren, spin him around, getting him pressed up against the cage.
He's looking to catch that leg every time it's thrown up at him. You don't want to be fighting on one leg.
Bibiano's got to be careful with that hand, keeping that hand low down by his chest. McLaren's throwing that left kick.
Ooh. Was that a slip or was there a bit of a sweep in there?
Ooh.
Right hand from Fernandez, just
that.
After a little left-hand feeler.
Bibiano lands a right hand.
Oh,
Reece McLaren,
push McLaren
look at
back.
Him. Shakes it off, smiles at him, says that did nothing. You don't want to take too many of those, McLaren.
Another right hand from Fernandez, and a left and a right, and McLaren gets caught again.
Now he's starting to understand the rhythm, and he goes for the takedown and gets it. Look how he laces up those hands. That's that long reach of Bibiano. Now he's got the back. Uh-oh, bad spot for Reece.
Looks to soften him up with the blows, and then go for the attack at close quarters. Thinking about the knee to the gluteus maximus.
Looks like McLaren's trying to think. He thought about kicking out and spinning around, but uh-oh, Bibiano's got the back now. He's got the body triangle. McLaren's doing the right stuff, though. He's fighting the hands, doing the good right stuff. You can see a little bit of damage on the mouth of McLaren there.
Yep, there's a small injury there. Shouldn't be a big problem unless it interferes with his breathing.
I think that came from that big right hand that he said didn't bother him, but it looked like it might have. Bibiano's starting to go for that rear naked choke. He's got the body triangle locked in. He's got about a minute and 50 seconds to work this position.
Oh, elbow to the neck there from Fernandez. And he unleashes another one, looking for the shoulder this time, the shoulder blade.
That's just part of the systematic breakdown that Rich Franklin was talking about. If you start elbowing somebody in the shoulder, if this fight progresses to the third and fourth and fifth round, that's gonna inhibit a lot of the punching. That's on his right side too.
And that figure four means that McLaren's not going anywhere for a little while. Readjusts, changes up.
See, during that readjustment period, that's that small window where Reece can create some kind of movement. But it's so tough when you have somebody the caliber of Bibiano on your back like that. You ain't going anywhere.
Is this the beginning of the end? Fernandez has less than a minute now to work this near naked choke, if that's what he's going for, and he plays to the camera. And the audience here at the Mall of Asia Arena saw that, and it's brought them to their feet in various parts of this arena. That's the kind of personality we're dealing with here.
He's just a fun kid to talk to. He's got so much personality and charisma. He just enjoys being in there. And I don't think he enjoys being in there right now, but he enjoys being in the experience. Now maybe he's doing a good job of defending. I mean, this is a world champion, third degree black belt on your back, and you're defending quite well.
Look at that shoulder taking all of that elbow punishment. Now, Bibby's got to be careful. He's okay. He's not hitting the back of the head. He's going for that shoulder. And it's bothering Reece McLaren enough to try and block the punches.
No, that's going to affect him later in the fight.
For sure.
You know, he's not going to be able to keep his hands up. It's going to be harder.
And remember, this one could extend for as many as 5 rounds. Big, expansive kick from McLaren that Bibby didn't quite get a chance to catch.
He likes that jumping karate kid kick, but it's just not really landing the way that he's trying to stomp the chest of Bibiano. But look at how Bibiano's able to close that distance. But he circles away, he's moving well, he's got good lateral movement, and he still looks fresh.
He's such a fun fighter, isn't he? He's another fireball of energy. I said the same thing about Mark Striegel earlier in the evening. Oh, and a big left hand. And that sent Bibiano Fernandes back a step or two. How will the champion react?
That was an impressive straight left hand there thrown by McLaren. It seemed to anger Bibiano. Now he's kind of going for him a little bit more. You gotta be careful not to rush in because Reece has still got power.
That's gotta give McLaren a little bit of confidence. He went straight in with a kick attack. Oh, and a big swinging left again. This time it missed.
Steve, look at Bibiano's nose. I think Reece shattered his nose.
Well, he just had a little pick at it there, so he's obviously bothered by it.
Yeah, Reece McLaren broke Bibiano's nose with that straight left hand.
And he's dabbing at it again, Bibby. Clearly bothered by that injury to the nose. And Reece McLaren is taunting the champion. Halfway through the fight, we're approaching that point, and McLaren has suddenly turned things around. Behind on Rich Franklin's scorecard, but that won't mean much if McLaren stops him. And McLaren is playing, sticking out his chin a little bit, grinning at him, opening those wide eyes of his, playing with the champion just as he did with our camera in the second round.
Look at the movement of the challenger. He's moving so well laterally. He's throwing strikes and immediately getting on his bicycle, moving those feet around.
Don't forget, McLaren is the upset specialist. He's just won his last two fights very much with that character. Will he do it again?
The champion has to get his composure here, close the distance, and drag this fight back down to his territory because the challenger is slowly inching ahead. This is exactly what he wants. Good defense by Reece McLaren.
Big left hand, and that may well have landed flush on the nose again. This means Fernandes will have trouble breathing. Clearly, he'll be in a lot of pain when punches land. McLaren is saying to the referee, take a look at that nose. Stop the contest.
Nah, they're not going to stop the fight over a nose. Bibiano's an absolute warrior. It's starting to bleed, though, now. Now it's starting to come out.
I think there's an external cut on Fernandes' nose. And that's what McLaren was pointing at. He'll get any advantage he can, any help he can from the referee. Bibiano Fernandes' night has changed dramatically.
The heart of a champion. Will it be displayed, or will the real-life Rocky story come through and shock the world?
Are we going to see another incredible upset? Does this man have anything more to give?
I don't know if we can call these upsets anymore, Steve. We cannot call him the underdog.
At some point.
Watch out. You okay?
He's putting on a show. Look at this.
We'll make him the favorite for a fight.
This entire third round has been contested on the feet, and he is showing striking superiority, excellent footwork, and damage inflicted is clearly evident on the champion's nose.
We've heard of headhunting.
Oh, the champion's going forward.
Is nose hunting, but he's had to take a couple of blows on his way to that point. A minute left in the third round. The championship rounds come after this. Somewhere that Fernandes has been far more frequently than his opponent. And Fernandes stays on his feet in this troublesome third round. You'd think with that nose, he'd be looking to take it downstairs, Mitch.
Yes, Steve, but this is the championship level experience. Bibiano has been in there against the best in the world, and he knows exactly how to compose himself, exactly what he needs to do. He might lose these 5 minutes, but he knows where this fight needs to take place. And there was a huge overhand right that hurt McLaren.
It did hurt McLaren. He brushed it off, but he's palms up saying, come on, you got more than that. Just a few moments ago, he shook him off, shook his head at Fernandes.
Oh, yeah, look at that big right hand. Reece McLaren better knock this off because he is angering the champion.
And the swinging right hand from Fernandes comes back. What a round this is. Is this the round of the year? The D88.com fight of the night must surely be a shoo-in. The bell for the end of the third.
The meat and potatoes of what the belt is all about.
Will we ever make this man, Reece McLaren, an underdog again? If he can do this to perhaps the pound-for-pound best fighter in the organization, he doesn't deserve to be called an underdog, ever.
Steve, I think the corner was able to realign Bibiano's nose and get it pretty much straight. That is some excellent cornering from Bibiano's team over there.
Make no mistake, he's still in trouble with that nose.
Yeah, but it is, but he corrected the alignment a little bit more. Now I think maybe his breathing's a little bit better, but nah, it's still pretty much a mess.
McLaren's still the busier of the two in terms of his movement. He's taking the perimeter of the cage. Fernandes is stalking him.
Look at that, he's able to take Bibiano down, but Bibiano popped right back up.
Left hand from McLaren comes in. He'll be nose hunting again, you can bet. There he goes again, big right hand from Fernandes. McLaren goes down, he bounces up and smiles at the champion once more. The grinning assassin from Australia.
But when fighters smile, especially like that, the tongue out might be a little bit different. But that hurt, that punch hurt him.
Doesn't stop it being annoying, though, does it, for the other guy? Takes a big, big breathe in.
I think it's a little bit of showboating, but it's also annoying Bibiano. You can almost see the visible frustration on Bibiano's expressions, the way that he's controlling himself. He looks like he's antsy, like he's trying to march forward and end this fight quickly.
Yeah. The weight of positivity has swung in McLaren's favor. He may not be ahead yet on the judges' scorecards.
Oh,
but
nice
that was
right
a clipping hand. Right hand, wasn't it? That landed nicely. McLaren will get a little bit of respite in this position just to clear his head, because that certainly cuffed him around the jaw.
Either way, Steve, win or lose, we are creating a star here tonight in Reece McLaren. He is putting on a show against the incredibly dominant Bibiano Fernandes, taking him deep into the round and winning a lot of it.
Midway point in round four.
Good defense shown by Reece McLaren. He's got this nice wide stance. He's holding the position well.
You saw that Rich had Fernandes slightly ahead. There was slightly more red perhaps in the Fernandes half of the graphic that we threw up, but the two more important categories showed advantages to McLaren, so it's very close on Rich's scorecard and I imagine the three judges at cage side. The final 7 minutes will write this story to a conclusion.
But the gas tank that McLaren has is really evident. Look at his footwork, he's still light on his feet. He seems to be invigorated by that third round.
So fresh, isn't he? He's very, very fresh, you're right. Clearly in great condition, trained for the fight of his life here against a man who he idolizes, to be fair. He said that he holds Bibiano Fernandes in great admiration. What a big night this is for the Australian. How big could it become? There certainly is external marking on the nose. It's not just an internal injury that Fernandes is struggling with. Breathing could well be a big issue. You can see that he's open mouth. That's an indication.
But one thing he's done, Reece McLaren stopped kicking. He stopped attacking the legs of Bibiano, which has kind of nullified the takedowns of Bibiano. He hasn't been able to catch anything and rush forward into the takedown.
Switching strategy mid-fight then. The Superman punch fell short.
Yeah, this is where the championship experience of Bibiano Fernandes is going to come into
right
play.
Right hand from
Bibi. Beautiful right hand by Bibiano. You know, the showmanship, the flashiness, the tongue hanging out, it's definitely winning the crowd over, but Bibiano is staying composed, staying relaxed, and now that frustration seems to be gone, and now he's landing some significant strikes.
Kick to the midriff, and McLaren is suggesting that was low. Great work from Olivier. Pause this replay, and in this moment that we had, give us your thoughts on who might be ahead now.
Well, I'll take you through the replay. It was right on target. And they're restarting already, so we'll just see where this takes us.
We'll get back to you. There's hardly a moment to breathe, is there?
Yeah, I don't think Reece wants to take the time. You know, he's definitely seeing the momentum shift, and he wants to get right back in there.
That's a great point. Yeah, why let the momentum die down if you're in the ascendancy? And he certainly looks confident, though. The touch of gloves before the final 5 minutes, and again, a lot of energy exhibited from McLaren, who makes a fast start to this final stanza.
The condition of this kid is exceptional.
He drives Fernandez into the cage.
Look at the balance of Fernandez. That takedown has worked on every single opponent McLaren has had. Now the damage a little bit more on McLaren's face. I think he might have took another low blow there, but he shook it off to stay right in the mix.
Our
he
first
wants to
contest.
Keep the momentum on his side.
Excuse me, Mitch. Our first contest that's gone into the fifth round tonight could well be our D88.com fight of the night. As I said earlier, it could be up there for fight of the year. The way that this one has turned around. Still Fernandez slightly ahead according to Rich, but McLaren has brought himself back into this contest after not quite being in it in the first 10 minutes.
I don't think the judges will be swayed by, you know, this display of just antics that he's displaying here, or he's kind of showcasing here.
It's a crowd pleaser.
It's definitely getting the crowd on his side, but it's also kind of got in the head of Bibiano a little bit, as just almost as much as that his fist did.
I think it might have done. You're right.
But McLaren is putting so much promise behind these punches. He's definitely improved in the striking game. But
this is also where the tremendous experience that Bibiano Fernandez has will serve him very, very well. He's been in wars, he's been in roller coaster rides. He knows how to bring himself under control, last the full 25 minutes, and get the best out of it.
Consistently pushing forward, Bibiano is trying to control the cage in the distance, but McLaren just doing a good job of staying light on his feet, picking apart his punches, and really whipping out that jab there.
What tremendous condition McLaren is in. With less than 3 minutes to go in this fight, he is still bobbing around.
Oh, that overhand right sets up beautifully, closes the distance well with it, and is able to get into that takedown. Now he's got the legs. McLaren's doing the right thing. Look at how wide that base is. Bibiano's gonna have to transition into something. I don't know if he can suck the legs out from under McLaren.
McLaren needs to have the better of the exchanges in this round.
Fight, break.
In order to edge himself ahead if we're going by Rich's scorecard.
That's right, let's go. Fight.
The fight judged in its entirety, not round by round. The judges will have this one pretty close. More damage on Fernandez's face. It's been a problem since early in the third round.
McLaren very active, and that right hand was landed beautifully on the chin of Bibiano.
Couple of
he
good
set
punches
it up really
through.
Well. Fainting with a jab, and look at the way he's switching
left hand
stances.
From him. And in the southpaw stance, that's his biggest punch. It was a bit of a slapping punch, but it landed cleanly. Bit of an arm punch rather than full body weight and shoulder moving forward. But at this stage, certainly point scoring.
Inside leg kick landed by Bibiano.
Good work
so
from the
heavy.
Hands. McLaren pulling off a nice 1-2 there as he came off the cage wall.
Nice body kick landed by Bibiano.
Gets one back, not quite as powerful from McLaren. The overhand right from Fernandez, who's still stalking his opponent. He's doing the chasing.
He circles out really well, so Bibiano wasn't able to press him up against the cage. He spun around, utilizing the cage very well.
Great appreciation from this crowd at the Mall of Asia Arena. A full house, and we're into the final 45 seconds.
Both fighters are trying to leave everything in the middle of that cage.
Who can leave their mark on this contest in the most indelible way? Fernandez.
Good takedown defense by Reece McLaren, and also to exit with some punches.
They both quicken up the action. Inside the final half minute, the crowd on their feet behind me. Applause and cheers ringing around this arena. Final 20 seconds, the kick to the head from McLaren. What has Fernandez got left? Can McLaren pull out anything that will capture the judge's eye? A couple of spinning back fists. He looks up to the giant screen and sees that he's inside the final 10 seconds. Fernandez throwing everything he has as the seconds tick away. His championship belt on the line, and it will go down.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds,
Head coach Summer Free.